The moon is just one of many mysteries on our globe. It is simple to overlook that our moon is an Earth-orbiting celestial body because of its ethereal brightness and enchanting beauty. However, what if our moon somehow managed to escape its gravitational pull? In this video, we will look into the possibility of a free-floating moon in our solar system and talk about the implications of humanity and Earth. We will explain why this scenario might occur and its likelihood. So watch the entire video to learn more about what could happen if our moon defies Earth's gravity. Almost 300 years ago, the well-known English scientist Edmund Halley first believed the moon was receding after looking at records of historical eclipses. When laser rays reflecting off reflectors placed on the moon by US and Soviet missions revealed that it was receding at a rate of 3.8 centimeters per year in the 1970s, his fears were eventually correct. Please give this video a thumbs up and subscribe to this channel for more information before proceeding. Click the bell icon to receive notifications of new videos. Have you already done this? Let's start. Is the moon moving away from Earth? The moon's orbit around Earth has a diameter of around 768,000 kilometers, 477,213 miles, yet it is becoming bigger yearly by 3.8 centimeters. You may already be aware that the moon and Earth are tidally locked, which refers to how their motions have synchronized so that we always see the same side of the moon. The bulge on Earth now tends to speed up the moon since Earth rotates on its axis every 24 hours while the moon revolves around the Earth in 27.3 days. To put it another way, Earth advances the moon in its orbit. The moon also pulls back on our planet's tidal bulge, which it helped form in the first place, somewhat reducing its rotating speed simultaneously. Because of this, a day on Earth will be 2 milliseconds longer than it is in about 100 years. The moon accelerates because Earth's gravitational pull is stronger than the moon's, and as the years go by, its orbit grows larger and longer. Even though an increase of 3.8 centimeters might not seem like much, when multiplied by the number of years in the billions, it adds up and becomes highly significant. Is it possibly conceivable for our moon to evade the gravity of Earth? The moon is never going to leave us. There needs to be a clear scientific explanation for how the moon may ever leave Earth, and the remote possibility that it only surfaces after Earth has been largely destroyed by the sun. The current pace of migration is only 4 centimeters each year. The arrangement of the continents and seas, as well as the Earth's interior structure, all significantly impact the strength of the tidal force. Scientists examined the inferred average rate of change in the moon's orbit over the previous 4 billion years to make a more accurate prediction. According to predictions, the moon's orbit will reach its maximum size roughly 50 billion years from now. A lunar orbit will take 47 days or 1 month by that time. Earth will take 47 days to rotate, which means that one side of the planet will always face the moon just as one side of the moon does now. The moon will stop moving away from Earth and no longer experience tidal effects once the system is aligned. What would be necessary to pull the moon out of Earth's gravity? After reviewing data on historical eclipses, the renowned English astronomer Edmund Halley initially speculated on the moon's retraction about 300 years ago, when laser rays reflecting off mirrors placed on the moon by US and Soviet missions revealed that it was receding at a rate of 3.8 centimeters per year, his fears were ultimately proven to be correct in the 1970s. The gravitational pull of the moon on the rotating Earth propels it. The Earth's rotation rate is slowed by drag from tides and raised in the oceans. The moon speeds faster and moves farther away to compensate for the angular momentum loss that results. That is the fundamental concept, but there is an issue. The moon must have separated from the Earth about 1.5 billion years ago, much more recently than the geological record indicates. Creationists have used this to challenge the accepted scientific theory on how the Earth and moon came to exist. Astronomers point out that due to continental drift, which changed the size and depth of the seas and hence the amount of the tidal drag, the recession rate will have been slower in the past. This causes the date of separation to be pushed back by several billion years by geological evidence. Why is the moon moving away from Earth? The Earth's tides are primarily responsible for the moon's movement away from the planet. The Earth's gravitational pull, which keeps the moon in orbit, is counterbalanced by the moon's gravitational pull, which moves the Earth's oceans and creates a tidal bulge. This tidal bulge sits slightly ahead of the moon because of how the Earth rotates. Friction transfers some of the energy of the rotating Earth to the tidal bulge. As a result, the bulge continues to move ahead of the moon. The moon is propelled into a higher orbit by the tidal bulge like the faster outside lanes of a racetrack by a modest quantity of energy. This phenomenon reminds me of what happens on a kiddie roundabout. The sensation of being thrown outwards grows stronger the faster the roundabout turns. The Earth's tides accelerate the moon, but the energy gained as it is pushed higher is balanced by a loss in the energy of its motion. As a result, the moon is being slowed down. How can this affect the Earth? The day's duration will lengthen as the moon moves farther from the Earth, which is one of the most significant and noticeable consequences. The gravitational pull of the moon causes the Earth to spin rapidly. The conversation said that only 16.9 hours made up a day on Earth 2.45 billion years ago. We shall experience days longer than 24 hours when the moon recedes. However, this will not be the worst thing to ever happen to Earth. The tidal waves would be one of the most noticeable effects. Oceans will still move slightly because of the sun's gravitational pull, but it will be tiny and insignificant. Numerous aquatic creatures would perish as most of the ocean's cold and warm currents would vanish. The coastline region will likewise undergo significant alteration. The effects of Earth's seasons would be the most detrimental. Because of the moon's alignment, our planet leans at an angle of 23.5 degrees. This alignment is to blame for the cold polar regions and typically consistent seasons on the Earth. The Earth would be a wobbling body, continually being pushed and dragged by various planets and celestial bodies if the moon were to move away, making the seasons and living circumstances highly unfavorable to life. We now know that if the moon were to defy gravity and leave the planet, inevitable disastrous catastrophes might result. Although there is a possibility, it's pretty unlikely and will continue to be so for a long time. All we can do at this point is pray that our moon stays in its orbit and take in the grandeur of the night sky, knowing that we no longer have to worry about anything. Today's video has come to an end. Remember to give this video a thumbs up and subscribe to the channel to view more videos. Remember to click the bell symbol to receive notifications when new videos are posted. I will leave you with this and hope to see you in the next video.